Welcome to Industry Giants 2018. I'm here with Robert Atkins, and I hope I'm pronouncing your name right. The maker of a game that is contributing to actually helping gamers solve real-world problems in the real world. So thank you very much for joining us. Appreciate you taking the time.
Yeah, my pleasure.
Well, we'd like to get a little more of a gist about what your product is, what your company is, and if you could tell us a little more about that.
Absolutely. So I've been making games for 25 years. I've been able to work on a lot of amazing titles, IP, like worked on the original Duke Nukem 3D, Quake, Star Trek franchises, Lord of the Rings, Tomb Raider, Counter-Strike, a lot of stuff that was, you know, high production value, you know, super popular in the industry. Mm-hmm. And, you know, so I've been very blessed to have been able to hire and work with a lot of amazing people. And about 5 years ago, I kind of came to a place in my career where I was like, I don't want to just make entertainment anymore. Mm-hmm. I want to make stuff that has like some meaning or purpose. And I really didn't honestly know what that was. I was like, maybe I'll go back to teach. And I started teaching at SMU Guildhall. At least I could, you know, be instrumental in helping people launch their careers and maybe helping them train the way they think something. You know,
right.
I really enjoy, you know, teaching and my mentors were always my professors and whatnot. So I really felt like that's it. Maybe that's it. And through that journey of like not accepting, you know, not accepting any limits to what I set out mm-hmm. to saying, I'm not gonna do anything that doesn't have purpose and meaning. I started meeting people. I met my partner Carl Laperouse, a friend of ours, mutual friend named Brandon Oldenburg, Academy mm-hmm. Award winner. He started Real Effects here in Dallas and nice. Went on to go work with Bill Joyce and Shreveport. That's where I met Carl. He's like, he pitched me this game at a coffee shop. He's like, I wanna show what's really happening inside the body. And I wanna be like for kids to be able to play and then know what's like what's trying to kill them, and they can treat the body and they wow. can learn, and there's this way that you can teach, and we know games teach, and it was like that's cool, that sounds like something I could get behind.
Right.
And I kept butting my head. I was like, I don't want to just make entertainment about mm-hmm. going inside the body. I kept saying we gotta quantifiably know that it makes a difference.
Right.
You know, we have to there has to be a way to do that. And how is that? And I didn't know. So I pushed that project off for like a year till we figured that out. We kept having conversations, mm-hmm. we kept doing research, and I kept butting our heads up to that particular issue. And it wasn't until I met my other partner, Dr. Corey Clark, who's Deputy Director of Research at SMU.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And Corey had been working on a technology where while you play games, you could actually be solving real world problems simultaneously. So
okay.
imagine a kid at St. Jude playing the game where you go inside the body and you fight cancer
right.
and you treat the body from the inside out. While he's doing that, he's getting a sense of understanding mm-hmm. and getting a sense of empowerment and starting to visualize winning the fight. Like
sure.
he's gonna win it. And at the same time, he's playing with his friends back home that he's been separated from and his mm. family. But underneath the game, it's not just entertainment, it's not just edutainment, it's actually processing cancer research at the same time. So the researchers now have a completely new tool, crowdsourcing problem solving, using human intuition to train machine learning.
That's wild.
So that they can now actually make an impact on their disease. And it's working.
That's
we've
really
actually
wild.
put it in front of kids. We're talking to St. Jude, we're talking to, you know, major organizations right. to start to roll this out nationwide. So and the cool thing about it is because it's technology, mm-hmm. It doesn't have to just go in our game. The 8th Cell is the name of the game. It doesn't just have to go in our game. It can go in any game.
Right.
We have it working in Minecraft. We have it working in the Unreal Engine. We have it working in Unity. We have it
That's
working in
incredible.
Hubert and Pac-Man. And so we want
wow.
to roll the technology out mm-hmm. to the industry. And while people are playing games, mm-hmm. spending a billion hours a week playing video games, 2.6 billion people worldwide, they can suddenly actually make real-world impact. Because most people, when I talk to them, I say, are you a gamer? They always say, yeah, I love playing. They start talking about their favorite game. And then it always comes around to the same thing. They say, I use games to escape reality.
Hmm.
And what we're doing is, why about you use games to create a better reality?
Right. Well, I think that's incredible. Can you give us a little more of a kind of a breakdown into how the actual effect actually residuate, you know, actually has plays out in the real world?
Right. So we have pilots that we've been working on.
Okay.
While it can, we're currently working in medical.
Mm-hmm.
It's problem agnostic. That means we as long as data is formatted,
mm-hmm.
we could be doing data in the oil industry, in the environmental industry, in banking, of course, we're not starting there. We're starting with things that people care about. We all have a body. We all care about our health.
Sure.
And we all are constantly being inundated with the fact that we have broken mm-hmm. healthcare systems. We work with SMU cancer researchers. Mm-hmm. They look at all these FDA-approved compounds. And it's a big math problem. Every one of those compounds have a mathematical mm-hmm. equation associated with them. Well, they're trying to figure out which ones of those compounds are play nice with each other.
Hmm.
So it's a big math problem. They have supercomputers, but if we can crowdsource it with all the gamers, we're creating all this processing power
sure.
that's free that we can give to these people. And guess what? It's a problem.
Right.
And the other thing is we've abstracted out the algorithm to the gameplay loop. So while you're simply playing a game, you're having fun, you're turning a red block green, you're flipping this mm-hmm. over, you're shooting this monster, you're actually affecting machine learning. And you're actually making, and what we're looking through that data set, and we're visualizing
yeah.
all these data in a completely new way. And the way it works right now is you could be running cybersecurity problems at the same time you're doing the cancer research, or antibiotic, drug resistance. Like I said, it's agnostic to problems. So suddenly, we're going to let all these gamers, who otherwise are just playing games to be distracted, and games have a lot of therapeutic value.
Absolutely.
Don't get me wrong. I'm not a game developer, so I wouldn't bash my industry. But now you have this whole new layer of things that we can do,
right.
as possibilities. And this is empowering other industries for the first time. And,
right.
and we live in a world where all this data is being generated, and we need new ways to look at it.
Absolutely. This is really wonderful to hear. I mean, I can see why you're going to get the award today, and this is fantastic news. It's also it's really wild, because I think a lot of people who certainly play games, not even necessarily to escape reality, but to enjoy themselves, to
right.
work through problems, to
absolutely.
Develop themselves like strategic mental abilities. This is a way to actually create, I don't know, just an impact, and they're actually helping do something meaningful.
Right, and so I think you're really touching on something that's the brilliance of it all.
Right.
Is beyond the technology. Is it's a new way for the individual person
mm-hmm.
to contribute.
Right.
And they feel like they're part of something. They feel like they're part
Absolutely.
Of the solution. They feel like they're part of the community. They're not isolated. They're
right.
not. They're not like, they're not, it's a new way to empower them. So they no longer like, and guess what? Crowdsourcing is the new power.
Absolutely.
And we can, as individuals, come together
right.
to make a difference on the things that we care about. And that's why we let the individual decide the things that get processed on their
mm-hmm.
computer, the things that they care about, the problems. We find groups that have those problems that need the processing,
mm-hmm.
that need the machine learning, and we bring them to the community so that we can service the community that care about those things.
And I think at the end of the day, most people want to help each other out.
Right.
And that's part of the reason that tapping into gameplay is so fundamental, because play is a huge part of ourselves. We
yeah.
naturally want to do it. And we naturally, I think, would love to be able to do something good with the play. All right, so how can people get involved and be part of this?
All right, thanks. Thanks for asking that. Well, right now it's early access.
Mm-hmm.
We call it early access to the future. If you go to bmt.world, you can download our human app, HEWMEN. And
okay.
you can download Human, and you can play some of the games that we have on there, and you can become part of the net and become part of this solution type that's through games and having fun.
That's wonderful. And is there any way people can contribute to not only playing the game, but also contribute to what you guys are doing?
Yeah, we're always looking for people who want to be part of the future, and so be part of this. I would love to talk to anybody interested, programmer, artist, otherwise, who want to come and contribute. I would love to have the conversation with them. They can reach out to me at my email address, robert@bmt.world.
Well,
no problem sharing that.
Well, thank you very much
yeah.
for sharing that with us. And I'm sure that a lot of people here at the Industry Giants Conference are creative and are aiming to do something meaningful with their stuff. So thank you very much for joining us, Robert. It was really
thank
great
you.
Talking to you.
Appreciate it.
Thank you. You guys have fun at Industry Giants 2018. Thanks for joining us.